calls in a moment to madness. Some of those videos, guys, are absolutely great. Do you come up with all the ideas? Do you sit around the circle and think, let's do this, let's do that?
Yeah, it's just...
On the whole, yeah. But, I mean, it's funny, we haven't seen a lot of those for a while.
You haven't seen those in ages.
No. A lot younger than us.
They all are.
I feel so old now, Mike.
Do you get a lot of ideas that you reject for videos? Any that you've been going to, really, thrown away?
It's a process of elimination, eliminating the ones that are too expensive or totally infeasible.
Once we wanted round shoes and we couldn't get them made, things like that. And
we wanted round shoes.
In driving in my car, we wanted wheels. We want the axle changed and the wheels, so the car will go up and down, but things like that are too expensive.
Do you all agree or not, or do you argue violently about them?
Sometimes we do, yeah.
It depends, you know, how strong some... I mean, Lee always gets his cranes and his wires to fly.
So, what about the current video? Who put in the ideas for that?
Well, actually, the chap who directed it put a lot of the ideas.
Yeah, John Mills.
We really kind of, we've done nearly all the things we wanted to do in our videos.
Yeah. You're very musical, your videos, in a way, sort of 80s musical.
I think we're just a bit slapstick at times, that's all, you know. Yeah, just...
Do you like that sense of humour? Because it's been prevalent throughout all your songs, really, apart from the very early ones.
I mean, I think, I don't think we try to be like that. I just think we just
act, you naturally
act like that, you know. Yes. I mean, you know.
I know, I know exactly. I was always saying yesterday, I did your first ever Top of the Pops with you.
Yeah.
Many moons ago.
Long time back, you're with me.
Back in the Stripling days. Right, so we've got loads of phone calls to get through and bargains to give away, and we have Jenny David on the line, so if you want to grab a grey one each. Jenny, good morning.
Hello.
Hello, you're through to the lads.
Hi. Were your parents musical?
Who do you want to talk to first?
Both of you.
Well, my parents, I don't know if they were musical. My mum and dad were Irish dancing champions. And, well, I suppose that'd be musical to dance. How about that?
Okay.
How am I doing?
Yeah, my mum sang a little bit, yes. She's a very good singer, actually.
What about your dad?
I wouldn't know, actually. I haven't seen my dad for quite a long time.
What about all your parents getting together and doing something? Irish folk singing, and they could all get together and make an album.
They could actually. Chris's dad plays a bit of guitar and flute.
My uncle plays the bagpipes.
That'd be a nice Christmas present for them on. You'd get them all into the studio and get them to do a song together for posterity, wouldn't
it? I don't know if they could afford it, though.
My dad used to play the fiddle.
And still does.
Yeah.
All right, thanks for your call.
Bye-bye, now.
Thanks, bye-bye. And we have Rachel Ward on the line. Hello, Rachel.
Hello.
You're through to madness.
Hello,
Rachel.
Did any of you get a Valentine's card?
Sorry?
Did any of you get a Valentine's card?
I've got a couple at the office. You know, our fan club members send them in. Yeah, I got a couple. Thanks, whoever sent them in.
Yeah, I got one.
Just one?
Yeah, did you get
one.
Any?
No.
You didn't? I sent it, but it must have got lost in the post.
How many did you get? Did I miss that? How many did you get?
None.
None?
Big R, everyone.
If the lads had known, they'd have sent you one.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Thanks. Okay, let's have some more calls in a moment. I must say that we've got your bargain to do, so if you want to drag that out, we'll do some more calls in a moment.
Oh, we've got a few things in it.
Matt Bianco, we sold them short. Our mathematician here added up wrongly, and they got 35, not 30, so sorry, Matt and the boys, if you're at home. 35 points, which is amazing. Right, the bargain this week is...
This is from the Flounder Firkin. Good pint of real ale. It's got nothing to do with that.
This is the thing that we're giving
away.
Thank
you. Sorry, Kate.
It's for any of you budding sailors out there. This is one of the uniforms that we wore in the Uncle Sam video.
A life on the ocean, woe.
A life on the uniform.
Feeling sick.
Right, that was in, Uncle Sam. You've got to tell us. We'll ask a question in a minute.
A little babby t-shirt.
A little Flounder Firkin for a little drinker who could be a big drink when he grows up.
A little hat.
Little hat.
Let's go with the outfit.
Well, go with the little head.
There's another sailor hat. That's in case you feel like promoting yourself.
Yeah, or if you want to be a milkman.
And some singles, signed singles and albums.
I'll show you her.
And some records, of which are too numerous to mention.
Some records.
No, they're not too numerous to mention. We have Madness Records.
We've got this one, which sounds a little bit like that one.
Goody, goody. All these goodies to give away. The sailor hats, the t-shirts, and singles.
Whoever rings in with the right answer...
Writes in with the right answer.
Because Mum and Dad have to pay the phone bills, they'll also get 18 pints of polypin of Dog's Bolt and Brillo. Why not? Dad should get something.
And we have a question for this jacket and all goodies, don't we? So, have you got the question?
The question is, and you'll be able to find out by watching the Uncle Sam video, if anyone has it out there, on video, who wore the jacket in the video?
Who wore this jacket in the video? Uncle Sam answers on a postcard to this address, which is appearing. Superstore, BBC TV, London W12 8QT. This jacket, all the goodies and the records yours, if you can tell us which one of Madness wore this jacket in the Uncle Sam video. Easy for Madness fans. Right, we'll put all this stuff away. Thank you for my t-shirt. And we'll take some more phone calls. Hello? Christopher Bull?
Hello.
Morning, Chris.
Hello.
You through to the lads?
this question's for both of you.
Cool.
If you were marooned on a desert island, what personal possession would you like to have with you?
Helicopter. Yeah, very good. I don't know.
Yeah, a saw probably.
I suppose a bit of string.
A saw?
Why? To make a boat.
A bit of string and a drawing pin, I suppose, or something like that. Something really useful.
You play a saw as well, can't you?
What would you take, Chris?
I'd take all Madness's records.
Oh, yeah? They'd probably melt though in that sun.
And also a signed autograph or photo.
What, of Madness?
Yes.
Just in case they happen to write it on a piece of paper and send it to you?
Yes.
Right. We get the message here loud and clear. Okay, thanks.
See you, CB.
Bye. I love the way it sounds. You take a saw, make a house, make a boat and escape, and then play it at the same time.
That's right. Fantastic.
Very genius. Anthony Bradley on the line. Hello, Anthony.
Hello.
You're through to the boys here.
Hello. I'd like to ask you what football team you support.
I'm a Chelsea supporter, actually.
Oh.
Okay.
Quiet. It went quiet here.
Sorry.
Careful what you say, people.
Yeah.
I just sort of go along and watch a few matches occasionally with the others, but I don't really support any football team. I used to support Arsenal, but I find, I don't know.
Who
do
you support?
Occasionally.
Hull City.
How are they doing?
The sixth in the second division.
Yeah, they're right out front at the back, aren't they?
Sarah supports Hull City as well.
Yeah!
Oh,
she is a Hull fan.
I can hear you.
Thanks for your call.
Okay.
Okay, right, we have time for a quickie from Neil Powell. Neil, time for a quickie from you.
What is your latest ambition?
Ambition?
Quickie.
Oh, quickie, quickly.
God, yeah, to be perfect in every way.
I don't know. Just to keep enjoying doing it, I suppose, being Madness, because we have quite a lot of fun with that.
Can you say hello to my mum, please?
Yeah, hello, Mum.
Hello, Mum.
How are you doing, Mum?
Hello, Auntie Jill.
Hello, Auntie Jill.
We haven't got time to go to them all, sadly.
Okay.
We'd love to. Okay, thanks.
All right. Hello, Pete and Pam and Dad. And
thanks to the Madness Boys and Nutty Boys for coming in.
Thank you.
We're going to be back to say goodbye in a moment. First of all, news of next week's program.